like just apes to you?
Well, that was a clip from Dawn of the Planet of the Apes, this weekend's newest release and the box office winner.
Looks so realistic, mm-hmm. But is it worth seeing? Here to let us know is our resident movie critic, Will Loper. What do you think?
Well, I hope you like your morning coffee with a side of dystopian future, because that's what both movies we're taking a look at today are about. But I'm happy to report you should help yourself to both, because they are both excellent. So first up, we have Dawn of the Planet of the Apes. Now, as soon as you're done saying that title and ready to mm-hmm. see the movie, strap yourself in for a thoughtful, thought-provoking, and just plain thrilling ride of a movie. Dawn picks up where Rise of the Planet left off. The simian flu has wiped out nearly all of humanity while making apes smarter and able to talk. Caesar, James Franco's test subject in the first movie, is leading a peaceful ape community in California's Redwood Forest. Peaceful until a group of humans stumbles in, that is. The humans, they just want to turn a dam back on for electricity, but it's in the ape territory. A truce is agreed on, but it's a very delicate threat. The apes haven't forgotten how cruel the humans were in their testing labs. The rest of the movie watches that thread bend every which way and explores themes of whether we all need to give each other the benefit of the doubt to try to keep peace at all costs, or if fighting is better. They hit us, so we need to hit them back harder. The problem with that approach is that the hitting can go on back and forth forever and we all lose in the end. And, you know, explosions and die, perhaps. The movie also does a great job of showing shades of gray. It's not just apes are evil, humans are good, or vice versa. There's good and bad on both sides, just like there is with anything.
It looks like that kind of tugs at the emotions, too.
It does, yeah. You know, it does have that emotional heft as well. I mean, mm-hmm. both sides, there's children and mm-hmm, that kind of get put in peril, and so you really feel it for that as well.
I just wonder how do they do that?
It's fascinating. I've watched a little bit of the making of, and basically, you know, there's like dots all over everyone. Andy Serkis, yeah. He played Gollum in Lord of the Rings. He played Caesar in this. And mm-hmm. so they put on a performance, they pretend to be apes, and then they just, you know, CG them over with us.
So what did you give this?
So the rating, I gave this 4 stinking ape paws. Out of 5. The only thing this movie needs is a Charlton Heston.
Yeah, isn't that the truth? Yeah.
Those are on this weekend.
Yeah.
Okay, so up next here.
Next, I had Snowpiercer starring Chris Evans. So this is kind of a smaller movie, but it's finally come to Madison. So Chris Evans has a beard. Again, short time in the future, humans, they explode a chemical in the sky to reverse global warming, but instead it causes the planet to go into an ice age. The only survivors are on a speeding train that has been traveling for 18 years.
Oh, wow.
So if you can get past that, in the front of the train are all the upper class people with the nice stuff, the back, the lower class folk who eat squishy protein bars and never bathe. Chris Evans and the rest decide a revolution is in order and they storm through all the train cars to try and take control of the engine. The movie's nonstop, it's incredibly clever, had my jaw dropping throughout. I will say there are a few plot points in the movie that nearly derail the whole thing, like how does the train keep moving without ever needing maintenance for 18 years? But you know, I think it stands up enough on its own that some of these plot holes can be forgiven. Because it's not until the movie was done that I was like, yeah, I'm starting to question some of the few things. So
It's kind of like Titanic minus the sinking. And it's a train as opposed to a ship.
Yeah, exactly.
With the classes.
Mm-hmm. And what's your rating on this one?
So I gave this one 3.5 Coca-Cola polar bears out of 5. I'm not going to explain that because it might spoil it. But if you see the movie, you'll know what I'm talking about.
Okay. And what's new this weekend?
New this weekend, we have The Purge Anarchy, the sequel to The Purge last year, and Sex Tape with Jason Segel and Cameron Diaz.
Oh,
so that looks somewhat funny. I don't know.
Okay.
Thanks a lot, Will.
Yep, thank you.